Leagues. Afternoon games underway with the Twins leading the Yankees 1-0 in the bottom of the third inning. Bottom three, Orioles on the board with two, Rays nothing. Blue Jays at White Sox starts in a few. In soccer, Poland beat Switzerland on penalties to advance to the quarterfinals of the Euro Championship. Rounds 2 through 7 of the NHL draft are happening today. Round 1 last night, a record 12 Americans were selected. Maple Leafs took center Austin Matthews from Arizona with the first overall pick. Listen to NBC Sports Radio on your local radio station, online, or on the free mobile app. It's Maria Marino, NBC Sports Radio.
This is KCAA.
We are the first people students see when they arrive at school. We are the secretaries that greet students with smiles. We turn on the lights. We keep schools clean and free of hazards. We help children learn to read, write, and think critically. We prepare and serve nutritious food. We are the watchful eyes on campus. We are classified employees. And we are the California School Employees Association, dedicated to educating students. Visit us on the web at www.csea.com.
This is Dick from Carpet Masters. Carpet Masters has been serving the Inland Empire for over 55 years. Carpet Masters uses extraction cleaning for your carpet because there's no better cleaning to remove the soil from your carpet. All of our furniture cleaning is done by hand in your home or in our plant. Carpet Masters also offers dry cleaning for fine furniture. Call Carpet Masters at 793-7215. That's 793-7215 for Carpet Masters.
Kcaa.
If you're booking a cruise out of Galveston, we suggest you add a few days to your vacation and rent a Galveston Island beachfront home. Our fully furnished homes are equipped with central air, washer dryers, dishwashers, cable, wireless internet, and unlimited telephone service. Step off the lower deck of your beachfront vacation home and walk 50 feet to the tide line, where you can fish for speckled trout, redfish, and whiting. Watch the pelicans, and they'll show you where to cast your line. Enjoy horseback riding on the beach, jet skiing, deep sea fishing, dolphin tours, Schlitterbahn Water Park, and the famous Moody Gardens. Tour historical homes, art galleries, and antique shops, and enjoy Galveston's nightlife with award-winning restaurants and live music from jazz to rock and roll. Our homes rent for less than hotel rooms on a per-occupant basis. Call 832-452-0528 or visit our website, www.texasbeachfrontvacations.com.
Hey, you. Yeah, you. Do you know where you are? Well, you've done it now. You're listening to KCAA Loma Linda, your CNBC news station. So expect the unexpected.
You just entered the gotcha zone. Eilon up to the start line and get ready to race with your host, Joe Britt. It's time for Gotcha Racing, live on KCAA 1050.
Ladies and gentlemen, start your engines and get ready for an action-packed, fun-filled hour of everything a motorhead ever loved or lived. Gotcha Racing with Joe Britt. Welcome to Gotcha Racing. This is Joe Britt.
Hey there, race fans, and welcome to another edition of Gotcha Racing Live with your host here, Joe Britt. I'm in the Master Command Center at KCAA Radio, one of the top radio stations in the IE. I should say one of the tops. No, we are the tops in the IE. But let me start with saying this. I come to you a humble man that is a reflection of God's grace and greatness, a humble man that is standing on the shoulders of ancestors. Hello, America. Look alive, California. Wake up, San Bernardino. Stand up and be counted. Oh, Inland Empire, because this is your host, Joe Britt, coming to you loud and strong and clear from the desert to the sea, broadcasting on the powerful KCAA radio, 1050 AM and 106.5 FM. Folks, we're having great weather today. I really love it outside. Really love the weather outside. It's been a while since I've been in, you know? I've been out and about. I've gone to car shows, and I've gone to events, and I've tried to broadcast my events. Oh, let me slow down. Now, in the studio, I have, if you guys can see, I got my two grandsons here. Okay, so I have, go ahead and welcome
Hello, America.
Go ahead.
Hello, America.
Okay, folks. Got to start them young. All right. I'm having a good time sitting in the commander seat here. Thank you, guys. Sitting in the commander seat here at Kcaa Radio. Okay, you guys are done. You made your debut already. Go back and sit down and watch me work. Okay. gotta love it. Go this way. Gotta love it. Okay, here we go. Let's do a little house cleaning here before we get started here. For you listeners out there that are somehow, yeah, I always say this, you're under a rock somewhere, you're in a tunnel, you're in a cave or something, and you can't hear this fantastic broadcast of ours, you can call in and listen on your smartphone, your cell phone, your dumb phone, your house phone, and that number is 832-999-1050. 832-999-1050. Now, you want to call into the studio and talk to me? Yeah, talk to me. That number, long distance, is 888-909-1050. Or for you local callers, that number is 909-888-5222 or 5224. Let me repeat that. For you local callers, you want to call in and rant or just tell me what's going on in the IE, car shows, whatnot. It's like a free plug, but just be nice with it, okay? 999-888-5222 or 5224. Now, you want to get online and listen to our previous podcast that we have? And there's a ton of them. I'll direct you to kcaaradio.com and go to our Saturdays lineup. You'll find me, yes, Joe Britt, and of Gotcha Racing Live, and pick and choose, okay? And we're on Saturdays, of course, all right? We can be found on Facebook under Gotcha Racing or Joe Britt or Gotcha Racing Live. You want to email me personally? jbritt, B-R-I-T-T, .kcaa@gmail.com, okay? I was going to have my, Larry the Entertainer, I always talk about this guy with all the multiple voices, and we have him come on from time to time and just cheer the crowd up, and it just says funny things. But anyway, guess what? He is not showing today. At the last minute, wouldn't you believe it, something came up, and maybe we can get him on some other time. Larry's, he's funny. He's really funny. A lot of different voices. He's a big character. Okay. Oh, so it's 10 after. Hey, Joe, let's see here. Folks, I got some interviews today that I want you to hear, okay? Like, I've been out and about at Arundel Speedway, and then there's a local car show that I was at in San Bernardino. So hopefully you guys from the local car show that was at in San Bernardino on 3rd Street, right in the plaza there on a Sunday morning. Hopefully you guys are listening because, you guys are have some really nice automobiles. And let's see if you're listening. If you're listening, call in when you hear your voice. Joe, without further ado, let's go ahead and put on one of those interviews from the Irwindale Speedway, folks. All right. Well, folks, I'm on the grid now still, and looks like I'll be here for another hour or so talking to all the racers. And I come across another youngster, 14-year-old, that is tearing up the Speedway. Hey, Johnny Dressler, how you doing?
Pretty good. Qualified first today.
Oh, did you? Oh, so I'm talking to the big chief then, huh?
Yeah, being the youngest one in the class, being able to qualify first is always a great accomplishment.
So how long have you been behind the wheel?
This is my second season in this car. Overall, I've been racing since I was 8 years old.
Another 8-year-old. I'm thinking, if at 8 years old, how can you touch the pedals, man? Were they modified for you or what?
First, we started off in go-karts, which is a whole bunch of different chassis. So we were able to start in that and did those for a couple years. And then we moved up to a bandolero and then into this. So we've always been moving up.
So now, this is your specialty, this the Legend car, right? Tell me about it.
It's a 1250cc Yamaha street bike engine, 1,300 pounds across the scales. Up in Vegas, we can go 120 miles an hour. Down here, we go about 80 to 90 miles an hour, and that's about it.
No kidding. In Vegas, so I guess that's a larger track then, right?
Yeah, in Vegas, we use a road course, which is longer straightaways and more corners.
So, the difference between an oval and a road course,
which one you prefer?
I've only done the road course a couple times, but to me they're both really equal. It's just really hard work trying to change the car to go to this setup to this setup, so we're always working on that.
Now, since this is a motorcycle motor engine in it, how many gears you got?
Five gears. Here we use four.
So on this track, 90, have you been able to get up close to 90?
Yes. We run really fast here. Definitely being able to be the first qualifier. It's always really tight field here, really good racing. So it'll be expected a good race tonight.
Okay, so what's next for you, man? I mean, after you've mastered this and you're first today, but if you start kicking butt, I mean, on and on and on, what's next for you?
We're hoping to start racing the late models, but that comes down to a lot of money. So we're probably going to stay in this for a couple years and just get to know the legend cars. Everybody in the upper division say the legend cars are the hardest car to drive, so we'll probably just stay in it for a while and see how we do.
So your backs, so your folks, I know they got your back, right?
Yes, they've always been right there to help me, even when times were rough, but we're always trying to get better and better.
So, at 8 years old, I'm stoked, man, because I think you'd be playing with Legos and stuff like that. Here you are racing, you're racing 8 years old. How'd you get involved in this?
Long story short, my grandpa bought a motorcycle from a guy, and I saw in his garage go-karts, and he got us into it, and just advanced from over the years.
Well, good for you, good for you. Okay, I'm going to give you 2 minutes. Your sponsors, get some shout-outs to whoever you like, and your sponsors, here you go, and this is from Johnny.
First of all, I got to like thank my mom and dad, Ferguson's Heating and Air, sold by Fox. Swiss Springs for supplying us the springs around the car, and to be honest, that's really all about it.
Dude, you've done this before, in front of the mic, right?
Yes, sir.
I can tell. That professionalism is coming out, folks, at age 14. I can't wait to see you at age 24, man.
Thank you very much.
What do you think you'd be driving at 24?
Hopefully a real car on the streets and maybe a little bit faster here.
Well, good enough. We'll look for you, man, okay?
Thank you.
Take care of yourself.
Okay, folks, you believe this? This guy's 14, those kid's 14 years old, and he is driving at speeds of over 100 miles an hour, not in California, but in Las Vegas. So, like as I said before, he's 14. He's going to be hell on wheels when he gets to, say, 24 years old. But anyway, Joe, let's keep going. Let's put another one on.
This is a family car. Dad's to the left of me. Okay, so let's interview this young man. Dude, how are you?
Doing great. Out here on Saturday night racing, so can't complain.
And you're doing what you love, right?
Exactly.
Can't beat that, dude. Can't beat it at all.
No, you sure can't. I love it.
How long you been racing?
Going on 9 years, and I'm 17, so started pretty young. And ever since I started, I loved it. So I'm here today and having fun.
So I guess they got you when you were in diapers and put you behind the wheel, right?
Not quite, but that was definitely, I don't think we were thinking of that then. It was kind of spontaneous, actually. And, I mean, we started, my dad owned the team as I grew up, so I grew up kind of around racing. I didn't grow up in a racing family, necessarily, but he always owned the cars, and so I came out here on Saturday nights when I used to play baseball, so when I wasn't playing baseball, and now I'm here driving.
So on the weekends, there's 52 weeks in a year. You're doing what?
I'm not quite sure this year. We're doing a lot more than we have been. I've had about one or two weekends off so far this year since we started. And I wish it was that way throughout the whole year. I'd love to be at the track every weekend possible, but it's expensive, as you know, and everyone else does. So, you know, I don't know. I mean, some stuff comes up as we go. Some stuff we have set in stone already. So, I know we have about 10 to 15 more races for sure. So other than that, I can't really tell you much, but I can tell you that I hope that we're racing more than what we have scheduled.
I can understand that because I believe that's in your blood. It's in your bloodline, right, the racing?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Can't shake it, huh?
No, I've tried. I mean, my dad, he likes to do it, but it gets expensive, so he's tried to get me into doing some other stuff. Like, I've been playing a lot of golf lately, but I don't love anything more than I love this, so.
You know, tell me about your car here.
Tell me about your car. We don't know. Tell me about your car.
Yeah, so it's a race car factory chassis. It's pretty much a stock class. Everyone's supposed to run that. There's different variations of chassis, but for the most part, everyone has a race car factory. It's like a spec motor. It's just a GM standard crate motor. Puts out about 420 horsepower. Limited suspension wise, conventional springs, shocks, and it's pretty much a stock class, so everyone's supposed to be, in theory, identical to each other. So that's what makes this class fun and makes it tight and fun to race with each other.
So from there, if everything is the same, it pretty much comes down to your skill level, huh?
Yep. It comes down to who can get their car handling the best. So crew chiefs are a big thing. Driver feedback's a big thing. Obviously, the driver has to know what he's doing, he or she. So, but yeah, I mean, for the most part, I think it's about, I say 60-40 crew. So 60 crew, 40 driver. It's all in the preparation, I think, and how you bring the car to the track. If you unload close, I think you have a better shot at being fast throughout the weekend. And if you unload a second off, it's just tough to get it close to the fast guys. So preparation's big, and the guys back at the shop do everything, help you out, and bring you to the track, and make sure you keep tuning on it throughout the weekend and getting it better.
Hold on a minute. What age you say you were?
17.
Dude, you sound like a seasoned pilot, man. Seriously? 17? So you've been... Somebody's put a mic in your face before, though, right?
One or two times.
You sound good at what you do, man. You sound very confident. Very confident in what you do. That's incredible to be 17 and piloting this rascal. So, let me talk to your dad, you know, and get his view on what's going on since he's a team owner. Hey, Dad, how are you?
I'm great.
Team owner, how many cars you have?
Well, I have a super late model that's in the shop right now, and then we have this one, and then he also drives for NTS Motorsports in the SRL Southwest Tour.
Dude, you got to be the proudest dude on this track to have your son piloting this. You came in, well, you qualified fourth today, but he's 17. He's got his whole life ahead of him, man. How's that feel?
Well, it's great. You know, I never thought I'd live vicariously through my children because I have four of them. But he's proved me wrong. It's very exciting to see my son succeed. He's one hell of a baseball player, and he decided that he liked racing better because he came to me one day and he said, "Dad, baseball is boring." And then he decided he wanted to be a pro golfer, but then he played with me, and I told him and I taught him that he wasn't ready to be a golfer yet, that he should stick with racing.
Now, Christian says he got behind the wheel at what age? Seven or eight?
Well, his first race was 9. How it got started was I took him to the golf course with me, and I let him drive the golf course. And he did a lot better than his older sister, so I asked him, I said, "You want to drive a race car?" And he said, "Yes." So we showed up, and he ran the last race of the Bandolero series when he was 9 years old. Started dead last, finished fourth in his very first race ever. And as they say, the rest is history.
He got hooked from then, huh?
He got hooked from then.
Well, good for you, backing your son up. That's impressive, man. That's really impressive because, you know, as you know, a lot of families don't stay together, man. But you guys you're driving, you're on the weekend, you're having fun, you're with your dad. Man, life got to be good. Life got to be good, huh?
Yes, it is. You know, the biggest thing is right now he races against his coach and mentor, Nick Janitis, who taught him everything he knows about driving. He's learning more now, but Nick was the catalyst of Christian's skill set. And now he goes door to door with him.
So, here we are.
Here's Nick. He just asked what you're interviewing.
Here's
my dad
Nick
for.
Right there. This is Christian. This is Christian's mentor, driving coach, and now his nemesis.
And this is Nick, right?
Nick Janitis.
Okay. Now, sponsors. I'll give you 2 minutes. Give it up.
Well, we have Millennium Reinforcing, Mr. Crane, Wallace Signs, Verico, D&D laser screeds, industry lift, Procast products. Who am I missing, Christian? That's pretty much about it. And of course, good old Dad.
Wait, we call Dad Deep Pockets. Deep Pockets Dad. Well, you know, man, the reason why I open my mic out to give out sponsors information, because without them, we're done. Without the fans, we're done. You couldn't put on a good show like you put on, like you will be putting on this evening. Okay, so I have to pay tribute through you to the sponsors. So I tell you what, we're on at 11 o'clock every Saturday, okay? And have your sponsors tune in so maybe they can give you some more love.
That would be awesome, yes, because definitely without all the sponsors and without the fans, there would be no fun coming here racing to empty grandstands just to see who can win. It's all about the show. And that's what it's about. And Christian could not be where he is at without all the love from his sponsors.
You know what? And that would be us from the interview. Well, one more. Let me go switch over here to Christian. What do you think about this track, man?
I have fun here. It's pretty racy. So, I mean, you can run up next to the wall or you can run down on the grass, anywhere in between. So it provides for great side-by-side racing throughout the race, typically. Lately, we've been having some single-file racing, but on the restarts, it makes for some good racing, side-by-side, door-to-door action, good short-track racing, and, you know, I like this place. It's my home track, so when the Touring Series comes here, which is actually June 18th, I feel like I have a little extra leg up on those guys because it's my home track, and I have thousands of laps here. But yeah, all in all, it's a fun track, and I like touring and getting to other tracks and broadening my horizons and places I had never been.
I got one more thing. Okay, good enough. Thank you, Christian. Now, I'm going to go back to Daddy. What's up, Daddy?
Well, you know, I told him he always needs to remember all of his sponsors. And I was very remiss in forgetting the sponsor that's been with him since he was 9 years old. Western Concrete Pumping, Charlie Reed, we love you.
There you go. There you go. Okay, folks, this is Joe Britt, and we're going to continue to walk on the grid and get some more interviews. Christian, thank you very much, man. Have a good race.
All right, thank you.
You know, folks, when I was a youngster coming up, and sure the difference in families, when I was learning to drive and getting behind my first car, my dad said, hey, without insurance, you can't drive, and you have to pay for your own insurance. So it's great to have some dads with deep pockets. But now we started from humble beginnings, and here we are today. And here we are today. Okay, I have a great guy on the phone. And folks, this is our warrior, our road warrior. And, you know, Chris always gives us great information about bikes. For you bike enthusiasts out there that are waiting to listen, I'm quite sure he has something tantalizing today to treat you with. So, Chris, how you doing, buddy?
Hey, Joe, how you doing?
It's all good. Look, as they say, man, it's all good in the hood, dude.
Hey, feeling the love, man. Feeling the love.
How you been, man?
Doing okay. Well, I hope I can live up to the hype of that introduction. Thank you. Yeah, you always challenge me every time you do that.
Well, you know, and I do that because you haven't let us down. You have not let us down at all. Not me, or not even the audience once. And I try to stick you in some kind of things, but you always seem to pull that rabbit out of the hat, man. You know your stuff. You know your stuff. So what you got for us today, man?
Well, you know, today we're talking about something a little different. And, you know, I know so a lot of times I repeat myself on stuff, but this one's something new, I think. And that is, you know, running our bikes, especially the newer ones. When I say a newer motorcycle, I'm talking stuff, you know, 95, 2000 and newer. You know, having been that I've been riding bikes back to, you know, dated to the 60s and 70s. So we're going to talk about top gear, you know, high gear running on motorcycles. And, you know, this will even apply to some of the other car enthusiasts as well. But, you know, I hear bikes running down the road a lot, and I can tell they're either not in top gear, or they should be on the freeway, or they are and they shouldn't be, which would be the surface streets or the residential streets. And I'll explain the reason why here. On the freeways, the highest gear on our newer bikes is generally an overdrive, and that is a gear of, I will say, a gear of no torque. It allows us to cruise and glide, gives us optimum fuel economy, minimum vibration, and it's just easier on the engine, easier on our bodies. And on the open freeway and open highways, you get up over 50 miles an hour or whatnot. That's probably a gear you want to be in. If you don't have to worry about slowing down in a hurry at all, or making turns or watching cross traffic, that's the best gear to be in. Get you the best fuel economy, easier on the engine, it'll drop you a few RPMs, and you cruise along. If you're screaming down the freeway, tacking out at 9,000 RPM or something ridiculous, odds are you probably need to go to a higher gear. And if you are in your top gear, you might want to consider changing that rear sprocket to a smaller teeth and ease up on that engine RPMs. The other flip side, we got, if you're running on the surface streets, that is, any place you've got cross traffic, driveways, kids playing, lights, and then also on the freeway in heavy traffic where you're down under regular running speeds, you don't want to be in that high gear. You probably want to kick down one and use the engine to control your speed. In fact, you should be using the engine to control your speed most of the time anyway. Your brakes are primarily for slowing, and stopping. But if you're talking about speed control, you want to be able to utilize the engine. It gives you more of what, like I call dynamic braking, using the engine to brake by just rolling off the throttle. Help slow you down quicker for traffic or getting ready for situations where the light may be changing or you see a car get ready to maybe turn in front of you. You roll off the throttle, cover your brake, not necessarily be on it, but use the gear other than top gear. If you're in high gear and you're running 35 miles an hour down the street, odds are your engine's lugging, getting ready to stall, and you don't have that stoppability of rolling off the throttle or being able to get on the throttle and get on the gas, get some torque, and get out of the situation as well. So it's pretty important to think about and keep track of what gear you're in. My bike, the newer ones, 02s up, 05s up, they have a little indicator light that tells me on the dash that, hey, you're in top gear, man. No. Idiot light for us idiots. So, mountain riding, that's another place where probably never want to be in top gear in your overdrive, especially coming down the hills, because what you'll do is you'll just continually pick up speed, and you'll have to be riding your brakes, and then they're going to overheat, and they're going to fade away, and they're not going to be there when you really need them.
You know what? Craig, hold on a minute. You know what?
Yeah.
Right there, I was thinking, now who in the heck will come down a hill in sixth or seventh gear? But there are some knuckleheads out there that would do that, man. And though the novice guys who just got the bike out of the dealership and gonna go for a run and really does not know how that engine and the ratio is supposed to be with the gearing and the braking supposed to be. And
exactly,
it's the craziest thing. Now I've heard that actually on the street. And a short distance where the guy is in sixth gear and he only has a quarter of a mile to go or something. And he's not really revving really hard, And it's almost to the point of sputtering out. But, those
exactly.
are the things.
Exactly. You can hear it, I'll even drop you down one gear to fifth gear because some of the bikes don't go up as high. Fifth sometimes is an OD as well. And, you got to just, a lot of times, even if you don't have a tachometer to look at your RPOs, you just listen to the engine of your bike and feel the throttle response as well. And again, like I was saying earlier, this can apply to the auto drivers as well. You're coming down those mountain roads and stuff. You know what? Kick off your OD. Go back into your third gear or fourth gear. I know my little Ranger I drive for work has, I think, six gears in it. And I do the same thing. I usually, if I get in heavy traffic, I kick it off. And it just gives me a little more control, and control equals safety every time. So But yeah, on motorcycles in particular, you know, all of a sudden you just get rolling down the hill and you realize, oh, you know, I was enjoying this nice quiet mountain view and realize that it's a little too quiet because my engine's just idling. It's not even, you know, there's no torque there. So
well, hold on a minute. You can also enjoy that view for a hot second when you're in a gully or you're over the side. Are you hanging by your life or your thread on the cliff? You can enjoy it for a hot second.
Enjoy that peaceful sound of wheels not on the ground, you know, for the moment. Yeah, sure. Real, followed by another real peaceful sound, yeah, the one we don't want to hear. So, yeah, no kidding, right? But anyway, that's my little tip for the day, you know, is pay attention to what gear you're in. Stay out of overdrive when you're on the surface streets and stuff. It'll give you a better control, better safety, quicker response to slowing and stopping and reacting to hazards in the road, or getting on the throttle to get out of a situation where somebody's, you know, done something that's put you in a bad spot. And then on the roads, utilizing that top gear just to ease up the engine, improve our fuel economy, and enjoy the ride.
I got you, buddy. Hey, thanks a lot, man. Great information, as usual. And I really appreciate you calling in. Hey, dude, have a good weekend. Enjoy the road.
Will do. You too.
All right. Thank you, man. Okay. Hey, Joe, let's now we have Andre. Andre is our correspondent for tires. But let's go and pay some of these bills for a hot second. Let's go and pay some of these bills, man. Got all these bills laying around here. Let's pay for some of them. Hey, folks, you're listening to Joe Britt. Got you racing live on the greatest station. I'm going to be bold and say this. The greatest station is in the nation, KCAA Radio, 106.5 FM and 1050 AM. Looks, folks, we'll be right back. And believe this, this is the station that leaves no listener behind. We'll be right back.
Oh, no.
Don't worry about a thing, pretty lady. You're in good hands with J&K Auto Body Paint and Repair. J&K Auto Body has been serving the Rialto area for years and are considered to be one of the oldest and the best auto body shops in town. The right people with the right tools and the right experience that can give you the service and the quality that you expect. 24-hour, 7-day a week towing is available. That's J&K Auto Body, 241 South Palm Avenue, Rialto, California. Across the street from the Metrolink station. Call us at 909-875-0400, 909-875-0400. That's 909-875-0400.
UNDI Auto Truck Parts and Wrecking is loaded with 15 acres of used, salvaged, and rebuilt parts for your car or truck. Sure, you could go to any wrecking yard, but UNI has what it takes. Expertise, high-quality products, and the finest customer service you'll receive anywhere. UNI makes custom drive shafts, furnishes full warranties on all their parts, and keeps up on industry changes. Call 909-888-6841. You'll be impressed by the fast and friendly response from the UNI skilled staff. You can also go to the Contact Us page and request a part. UNI hours of operation are Monday through Friday, 8 till 5, and Saturday, 8 till 3. UNI Auto Truck Parts and Wrecking is located at 1435 West Rialto Avenue in San Bernardino. Check out the UNI webpage at the letter U, the letter I, autoparts.com, or call 909-888-6841. 909-888-6841.
Gotcha Racing Live, heard only on KCAA, is your command center for racing news, the hottest interviews, and DIY projects. We are your destination for interviews with racers and fans, on-track interviews, in-shop interviews with engine builders, car restorers. Hear from our correspondents on live track, car shows. Gotcha Racing Live. Start your engine and race on over to KCAA 1050 AM, 106.5 FM every Saturday at our new time, 11 AM. Gotcha Racing Live, where we put you in the driver's seat.
شما در حال گوش دادن به برنامه گاتچن ریسینگ هستید با صدای جو بریت. Sie hören jetzt Gotcha Racing Live mit ihrem Gastgeber Joe Britt.
You're listening to Gotcha Racing Live on KCAA 1050 AM with Joe Britt. Now get to the chopper. Hasta la vista, baby.
Okay, we're back in the driver's seat here at the biggest station, the greatest station in the nation, Kcaa Radio, 1050 AM, and also 106.5 FM. Okay, correspondent Andre for the tires. Are you there?
How you doing today, Joe?
You know, running my mouth as usual.
Oh, yeah. That's good. You're doing an excellent job. Keep up the good work.
Oh, thank you, brother. Thank you, thank you. How you been?
Yeah. Oh, I've been excellent. How you been doing?
You know what, man? I've been going to a lot of shows, been kind of busy. It's kind of weird being I've been away for about 2 weeks from the seat here in the back of the mic because I've been at, let's see, Run What You Brung, and then I had to go to a state convention. So I've been out there hustling and bustling and doing what I do best, you know, helping my community in one way and then getting information from the motorsports industry. So, and a lot, this is summertime, so it's very busy. A lot of things are going on. But sure. What's going on with you, man?
Yes, those are, I'm going to tell you like I tell the rest of the guys, those are good problems. And the problem would be if you're sitting around doing nothing. That's a serious problem.
Listen to you, sitting around doing nothing. Yeah, right.
So yeah, that's a serious problem. But at least if you're busy, those are good problems.
That's right. That's right. Let me get giving, there. You go. I was gonna say, Let me get your open.
First, giving the honor to God who's the head of my life. Today's topic is on air pressure. I talked a little bit about air pressure. Maybe about a month ago, but I want to do the whole segment on air pressure.
Okay, dope.
Okay, on air pressure, what you want to do is don't check your air, like on the outside of a tire, it has the maximum air pressure you will put. A lot of people mistake that, and they'll put the maximum amount. They'll read on the outside of the tire, and they'll say 44 PSI, but that's max. You don't never want to do the max because after you get road friction or whatever, the air expands in the tire and it goes up maybe to 54, 55 pounds of pressure. So if you're on the freeway and it's hot that day, that tire is liable to explode if you put too much air in.
Okay, wait. Hold on. Right there. PSI, mm-hmm. For you folks who are wondering, okay, I've heard of PSI before. What could that stand for?
Pressure. I have to do research on that. That's a good question.
Pressure for square inch.
Pressure per square inch, yeah.
Pounds per square inch.
Pounds. Yeah, I think it's pounds per square inch.
Okay.
So you want to have that, not, you don't want to have it maxed out. Because if you max it out on the top, on the road friction, and when the air expands, it'll go up too hot. So you want to make sure you look inside your door or your owner's manual and get the proper air pressure. Because it might say, if it say 44 pounds PSI and you'll go down to 34, you know, it might say inside your door 34 pounds. Then after it gets hot, it'll go up to 44. So you want to do that. And another important thing, too, when you check your air pressure, normally we lose a pound of air pressure per month, you know. So what you want to do when you check your air pressure and your tires, make sure you check your spare, too, because a lot of people never check the spare. And when they get out on the freeway and they have a flat, they go check the spare and it's flat. So always, when you check the air pressure in your vehicle, check your air pressure in your spare. Normally, it'll be way higher. It'll be 50 or 60 pounds on your donut or something like that. But you want to make sure you check that. And that's very important. So those type of tips, that way we use,
Joe.
If you have a flat, if you have a flat or anything, you're ready. If you have a flat, you can go in your spare and it's aired up. So you want to make sure of that. But most of your specs, and if you put some aftermarket wheels on your car, when you're getting to put on, ask the technician what's the air pressure, so you'll keep the air pressure in check.
Okay, so here's a silly question, Andre. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say you have air pressure is supposed to be 40 PSI, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And you've been floating around for 2 months or so, and your air pressure is at like 30. What does that do to the tire?
Oh, that'll wear it out. It'll concave like in the middle. Normally, when it's underinflated, the middle won't be flat. It won't be on the flat surface of the road, normally. And it'll wear like the corners of the tire. So you want to make sure, and you don't want to overinflate it too, because a lot of times you overinflate it, it'll wear out the middle of the tire. So underinflated normally wears out the edges, and overinflated wear out the middle. So you want to keep up on that. And pay attention, like when you walking up to your car. Normally, I walk up to my car. First thing I'm looking at is the tires. In the morning, I look at them because it might get a nail in it, you know, in the down overnight. So always be aware of your tires, because that's very important for your fuel economy and everything. The air pressure is very important. And the wear of the tire. You know, keep the life of the tire and the wear and the comfort of your ride. The comfort of your ride depends on that. A lot of people, they come into the shop, my car is riding hard or something, you go check the air pressure. Yeah, but that's 50 pounds. Oh, I just like to run it over. No, but that's why you is running rough. You know, you don't have that comfortable ride.
Okay.
So they said, oh, okay, I didn't know that. Yeah, okay. We all learn every day.
Here goes a common sense question for you. When your tire is wearing down on the inside, that's caused by what?
Alignment, most of the time. Mm-hmm. If it's wearing out on the inside, normally your alignment is out.
Okay.
You know, from the toe being out or something like that, your toe will be out or your camber will be out, and it'll wear the inside of the tire. Normally on your alignment.
Okay.
If your insides are more.
I've seen a lot of these little small imports, and they're so cambered.
Yeah.
In the rear, I don't know how they're getting a good tire use, man.
Yeah, yeah, they wear them out fast, because I have a couple of friends have it like that. Yeah, the camber is just so, it's so towed in that the tire kicks out, it'll wear out the inside of the tire. Oh, they might get maybe 2,000-3,000 miles out of that tire, maybe. Mm. They wearing them out pretty quick. Well that way, they put the camber like that so it'll tuck under the back fender. A lot of times, you know, they tow it out so it'll tuck under the fender.
So you have to pay so you're paying for that look, right?
you're paying dearly. Most of them guys not going too far, you know.
wait. So wait, Andre. So if you're up north, I don't think you'd be making a round trip.
No, you ain't gonna be from San Diego
to up north.
You're gonna be looking for some tires by the time you get down this way. So, most of those guys ride local. You know, I see them. You hardly ever see them on the freeway unless they're going to a show or something.
Yeah.
But that camber is so. And then they put. Yeah, say like this here, Joe. They put a 1510 on a little Honda Civic. You know what I'm saying? And that's sticking out, protruding past the fender wall. And then they gotta turn the camber in, so they wearing tires big time, and stress on the wheel bearing.
Mm-hmm.
So,
mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you gotta look at all that type of stuff. A lot of people they just come in and say, "Hey, let me put this kind of wheel." And then when you start explaining to them, you know, the damages they doing, then they say, oh, thank you for telling me that. Now I know. So, I mean, best thing is give them information. Now, what I normally do is give them the information. Now, if they want to do it after I give them the information, then they already know. They can't come back and say, oh, I didn't know that. No, I gave you the information.
I got you. Well, dude, as you know, you've never let me down. The correspondents we have for our show, these guys are very knowledgeable. very knowledgeable. They've been in the game a long time, and like you, Andre, you've been in the game a long time. And the listeners, I know they're getting they are getting their money's worth out of you, man. So I really appreciate it. Really appreciate
it. Yeah, I appreciate being in the family, and God bless everyone, and have a safe weekend.
Have a good fourth, man. Fourth is coming up. Have a good fourth. Be safe.
You too. Be safe.
All right.
Okay.
Take care. Okay. All right. Joe, let's put in a couple of commercials, and then we'll go to the see if we can put some lowrider stuff on. Folks, this is Joe Britt, Gotcha Racing Live, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM on the greatest station in the nation, Kcaa Talk Radio. We'll be right back.
Don't worry about a thing, pretty lady. You're in good hands with J&K Auto Body Paint and Repair. J&K Auto Body has been serving the Rialto area for years and are considered to be one of the oldest and the best auto body shops in town. The right people with the right tools and the right experience that can give you the service and the quality that you expect. 24 hours, 7 days a week towing is available. That's J&K Auto Body, 241 South Palm Avenue, Rialto, California. Across the street from the Metrolink station. Call us at 909-875-0400. 909-875-0400. That's 909-875-0400.
UNDI Auto Truck Parts and Wrecking is loaded with 15 acres of used, salvaged, and rebuilt parts for your car or truck. Sure, you could go to any wrecking yard, but UNI has what it takes. Expertise, high-quality products, and the finest customer service you'll receive anywhere. UNI makes custom drive shafts, furnishes full warranties on all their parts, and keeps up on industry changes. Call 909-888-6841. You'll be impressed by the fast and friendly response from the UNI skilled staff. You can also go to the Contact Us page and request a part. UNI hours of operation are Monday through Friday, 8 till 5, and Saturday, 8 till 3. UNI Auto Truck Parts and Wrecking is located at 1435 West Rialto Avenue in San Bernardino. Check out the UNI webpage at the letter U, the letter I, autoparts.com, or call 909-888-6841. 909-888-6841.
شما در حال گوش دادن به برنامه گاتچن ریسینگ هستید با صدای جو بریت.
Sie hören jetzt Gotcha Racing live mit ihrem Gastgeber Joe Britt.
Okay, I believe we're back. So, as I said, you know, I was walking and talking at a local car show. So, let's see if we can put one or two of those on. Now, this is probably about a month and a half ago. Go ahead, Joe, load one up.
Okay, numbers look good. Okay, folks, we are in the pits, and I am with the team RPM. You know, and pretty soon we'll be walking one of the legends down to the track, and so we can see you run.
Yes.
Today.
I run the legend car.
Okay. And your dad. Dad is the deep pockets guy, right?
Yeah, I'm the deep pockets guy.
Okay. Tell me about this event.
This event? Well, this is, first of all, this is a Memorial Day event, so we're here to honor our veterans.
Okay.
And second of all, we're here to just have fun with our kids.
Okay. So this is your son?
Yes. All right. My son.
So how old are you?
I'm 19.
And what's your name?
I'm Danny.
Okay. Danny, so how long have you been racing? Racing, period.
Well, racing, period, probably about 9 or 10 years at this point. This particular car, I've had about 4 years.
Really?
So, yeah.
Okay. So when you're behind the wheel and you're on the track, what goes through your mind, man?
There's not much time to think, really. You just kind of got to let instinct kick in and just kind of do what you know how to do, you know, let the car do what it can do and just do what you know how to do and everything will smooth itself out. And, you know, if you're smooth and you have fun, you just don't overthink it, you'll be fine.
Okay, now tell me something. On this track here, the short track, your speed's what, 90 miles an hour you can get up to?
Not quite. Here we run about 70 on the little 3/8 mile inside track. We go about 70 to 72-ish, I think, is the highest we've seen in a while. So it gets going. It's still freeway speeds, but
I think they're up to 90 miles an hour.
Well, in the straightaway, maybe. I mean, you look at average speeds.
Like an average speed.
Today, qualifying, were you comfortable? How'd you feel?
Well, qualifying, a little bit uncomfortable because I didn't practice all day. Came from my cousin's high school graduation, actually. So got here late for qualifying and just kind of went out there and hacked around for a few laps. So didn't qualify all that great, but, you know, I know what I got to do in the race. So
you're going to put it down, right?
Going to put it down.
Okay. Pops, now, your team consists of how many race cars?
Well, I have two. And I can't say that this is my third car. I'm going to say that's my son's car. But I have two late model racing SRL cars.
So how long have you had the bug?
I've had the bug since the early 80s. Too long.
Okay. Now, you started your son. How many sons do you have?
This is my only child right
okay.
here.
Okay. So you started him in diapers, right?
Just about. No. You know what? He knew what a bandolero car was before I knew what a bandolero car was. And he wanted one of those when he was about 8 years old. And I said, nah. But then a couple years later, we decided to buy him one.
Man, isn't it good to have a pops like that?
It's great. Couldn't ask for a better dad, of course.
Wait. You better put some more butter on that bread, man. Come on.
I love you, Dad. Thank you so much for everything.
Oh, you're welcome, son.
And that's how it works. But nevertheless, today's run. Are you, how'd you place?
Well, qualified again, towards the back or whatever, because, you know, not much practice time or whatever. But I think it's just a matter of, you know, gauging some other cars in front of me, figuring out where my car is better, because, you know, I know what the car is capable of, I know what I'm capable of, so it's just a matter of figuring out their weak points, my strong points, and capitalizing on those.
So it's a chess game.
It is a chess game.
All right. So now all the cars are pretty much built the same, suspension, motor, and the whole shot. Mm-hmm. So it pretty much comes down to your experience level and I guess how tough you are.
I suppose so. You know, it's a lot of surprising amount of stamina for how short the races are. You're constantly turning on a track like this. And of course, in the shop, there's stuff you can mess around with. Of course, you know, the motor's stock, a lot of the parts are stock, but you can try different setups and stuff, all kinds of different things to try to get it to handle a little differently. And, you know, but you're correct. A lot of it is driver. And, you know, a lot of it's commitment to getting in the shop and seeing what you can do to make it better.
So now tell me something. After this Legend Series, where do you go, man?
I'd love to run a SRL Tour car, one of the bigger cars that my dad's got. And I think ultimately what I'm going to college for anyways is I'm hoping to be a, you know, it's a pipe dream at this point, but be an owner driver at the Sprint Cup level would be something really cool. So
Hold on a minute. It's not a pipe dream, man. If you want it, you get it. If you want it, you got to put everything in action and everything will fall into place if you want it bad enough.
The
it's up to you.
The first piece of the puzzle is wanting it.
There you go, right? Man.
Having the dream.
And here we are today. So
it's not a pipe dream, brother.
Better than doing nothing.
You're here. A lot of guys are sitting at home, maybe watching you on TV. No, brother. The first step, you've already got it. You got your confidence level up, and you got your dad backing you. Dude, you can't have a better no better combination than what you got right here. You don't know how blessed you are, man.
I guess there's no reason why I couldn't do it.
That's
you
know, right.
There you go.
Never say no.
Never say no.
You got the whole team right here. So good enough. Pops, Dan, you've been in the game how long?
Probably 25 years.
25 years.
Yes.
Okay. And there's a lot of, this game has changed so many times. What's going on with the industry right now?
Well, I don't know. I don't think West Coast racing is as great of a sport as it used to be. And I think part of the problem is that there's so many other options for fans, you know, audience to go see. I mean, that's kind of the trend that we're seeing is it's not as popular of an audience coming to watch a sport as it used to be.
You think, or do you think it's more heavily watched Midwest and on East Coast?
I do. Absolutely.
Why do you think?
I think that racing is part of that culture back in the East. There's more racetracks that are surviving and they're staying open. You know, it's like Little League Baseball is to us out here, where the kids can go race five nights a week.
What can we do to keep the tracks open, man, here on the West Coast? So your kids like your son and other kids coming up would have something to do on a Saturday and Sunday night.
Well, I'm not sure if I have a 100% answer for that. It would be nice for the tracks to work together to keep the sport alive out here. And we have a couple of great people, like Andy Daddario has saved a racetrack up in Madera, for example.
Oh, I've been there.
Have you?
Yeah.
That's a great little racetrack. You know, somebody kept that track from being taken over by Lowe's a few years ago. And what we really need is more people like that who have a passion for the sport, who want to keep it alive out here.
Well, you know, it's absolutely needed out here. And I like Madera. My folks live in a little peach of land called Chowchilla, California, which is right next door.
Right.
Right. So whenever I do go up there, I always hit that little NASCAR track. Not bad, right. Not bad at all.
Yeah.
So, sponsors, shout out right now if you can.
RPM Motorsports. We have Rug Runners. We have Sims Trucking. And
Mom and Dad.
And Mom and Dad. That's right. Mom and Pops. RPM PSI.
You know what? Thank you for your time and much success to you.
Thank you very much, Joe.
In this industry.
Thank you very much.
Take care of yourself.
Yes, you too.
Right.
Okay, folks. You know, we tried. We just couldn't put it in for the car show. I'm going to have to do that next week. I promise I'm going to do that next week. But anyway, I have a good person on the phone that we go back and... Well, let's. Without further ado, Bev, are you on the line?
Yes, I'm here. How are you, Joe?
Hey, look at that! Look at that! Look what JP did for you, giving you an applause and everything. You're real special today.
Well, thank you, and you are very special too. And yes, we have a long history and a very fun history.
So, what you got?
Well, I just wanted to remind all of our listeners that on Wednesday. June 29th, this Wednesday coming up, from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m., we're going to be doing our 4th of July show by having a contest. We're going to have a first and second place winner. We're asking all of our listeners to send in their favorite recipe for potato salad or baked beans, and they can send it to our radio station, KCAA 1050 AM, at 254 Carousel Mall, San Bernardino, and zip is 92401. And on our show on the 29th, Alan Boygan from Let's Dine Out, he is going to be with us, and he is going to pick the two winners. And so what we're going to be doing, the first place winner will receive a gas grill from our good friends at Lowell's in Redlands. And the second place winner will be receiving a gift basket from Trader Joe's in Redlands. And also, we have two more huge, huge special things coming through. But they just have to tune in on this Wednesday, on June 29th, from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m., to hear all of these fantastic things. And also, you're going to be with us on the show on Wednesday, which is going to be absolutely fabulous.
Okay, so what show is that called, Bev?
It's called Let's Go Shopping with Bev.
Okay. And folks, that's coming up. And give me the date again, Bev.
It is going to be Wednesday, June 29th from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m.
Okay. Great. Well, I'm glad you were able to get that out over the broadcast. You know what? So I think I'm going to have a blast with you. I think it's going to be a good time on that day. So, folks that are listening, tune in if you can. Hey, this is Joe Britt, Gotcha Racing Live, coming to you broadcasting out of the powerful KCAA radio station on the West Coast, where the big dogs in the area, roof, the big dogs, because we carry the big stick. Joe Britt, Gotcha Racing Live. Next Saturday, 11 o'clock. See you soon. Have a good one. Take care.
You're listening to KCAA, Loma Linda, California. The best station in the nation.
Your NBC Sports Radio update starts now.
Back to the Big Apple. This is Maria Marino. 33-year-old shortstop Jose Reyes has officially returned to his original team, signing a minor league deal with the Mets today. Major League Baseball had suspended Reyes without pay through May 31st.